So you're just along for the ride, are you?
Look, I'm smart, and you're not.
Well, you're going to get a chance to prove that very soon. Because I've done a little deal with a freak.
I trusted her as far as I could spit.
Well, she won't be playing any games this time. The stakes are too high.
Oh, yeah, like what?
Like getting Reno out and getting Ferguson in her chair.
Come on, Winter. She'd make life hell in here.
Seems like you're not so smart. If Ferguson makes governor, she's going to owe it all to me. And I won't let her forget that. She might be sitting in the chair, but I'm going to be calling the shots.
Unfortunately, a lot of the books have been ruined.
But why? It's such a senseless act.
Don't know. Unless something of value could have been hidden there and they were trying to find it.
Drugs?
Well, could be. Although I've seen no evidence of it.
Meg, have you noticed a sort of underlying tension during the last couple of days, or is it just my imagination?
No, it's there. But I think Mari Winters caused that.
Well, thank God Myra's back.
Well, I don't think it was meant to get your mates into trouble. I think this was meant to get Reno into trouble.
You're kidding.
I wish I was. I think the freak's going to make a run for governor. We're going to have to do something about that.
But we're going to need something a bit stronger than that if we're going to bring the walls down around the governor's ears.
Oh, yeah? Any ideas?
A solution. Wentworth is now going to have a full-scale riot. You reckon you can handle that, Winter?
No worries, Governor.
Hi. Need some company?
Well, I'm not going to be much fun at the moment.
Yeah, join the club. We've really laid it on you, haven't we? Expecting you to fight all our battles for us. This doesn't seem fair.
Them's the breaks, I guess. Myra will be back soon. We'll just have to hope that all hell doesn't break loose before then. And what's on your mind?
Me?
Yeah, something's bothering you. You want to talk about it?
Yeah, well, my dear agent, the Lavender Leech, came to see me today. Oh. Guess what? He's decided to blackmail me if I don't do what he wants.
Blackmail?
Yeah. Remember I told you about Howard and why I killed him? Yeah. Well, that wasn't everything. When I first got started in the business, I needed some money, so I did a couple of porn pics.
Oh, me.
Yeah, there were movies, actually, and it was years before I met Howard, but the trouble is he managed to get his hands on the films, and, well, when I told him I was going to leave him, he threatened to make them public. I did kill him, but I didn't ever get my hands on the movies.
And now Roland is blackmailing you.
Yeah, sure is. If I beat this murder charge, well, he'll have total control of my life while he has those movies. If I lose, I'll spend the rest of my life in here. He sells the films and makes a small fortune.
So what are you going to do?
Well, what I should have done in the first place. I'll break the story myself. Everything. From the porn pics to the orgies Howard organized. Oh, I'm finished in the business anyway, Jude, but I swear I'm going to go out with a little dignity. And believe me, few heads are going to roll right along with mine. If people get hurt, well, that's just too bad. They'll be the same people who've been hurting me for years.
And how are you going to do all this?
Well, I'm going to make a phone call to an old friend of yours and mine.
Camilla Wells.
G'day. Thought I heard the television.
Turned it off. Nothing good on anyhow. It only roused on me.
Oh, what makes you say that?
Well, you went off here this morning. Your orders are all the bloody same.
Just watch your mouth, young man. Now, I had every right to be upset this morning. You're a child, Shane, and children do not stay out all night.
How would you know? You never had any kids. All me mates...
I don't care about your mates. Now, you undertook to live by my rules and you've broken them. Now, I don't like punishing you, Shane.
Go on, hit me then. I don't care.
You will lose half your pocket money for 4 weeks, and if there's any more nonsense, you'll get nothing.
You mean old bag. Why don't you just send me to one of those places? Anything's better than here.
Sit down, Shane. I said sit down. All right, I may be a mean old bag sometimes, but we have to get to know each other, don't we? And I don't want to spoil your fun.
Oh, you could have fooled me.
If I didn't care about you, I'd let you do anything. But, well, I worry about you because I don't want anything bad to happen to you. Makes sense, doesn't it?
Yeah, I suppose.
You know, I was pretty scared last night.
Yeah, well, I guess it was real dumb to stay out like that. I mean, see, your dad never cared what I did. It's real strange being here.
It's pretty strange for me too. But I'll give it a go if you will.
Well, if I'm good, do I get my pocket money back?
We'll see. Now let's eat.
I could go down to chip shop if you like.
You'll do no such thing. You're going to eat a properly balanced meal. And I'll cook something for you to heat up tomorrow night. Right? I've got to work late, and I don't want you eating takeaway rubbish.
Oh, come on. I can cook my own tea. I'm not a kid, you know.
No, no, of course not. Anyway, if I get my promotion, we can celebrate. New clothes for both of us, and you can take me out to dinner.
Hey, great. Only, I hope you like fish and chips.
Good evening, madam. I represent the Acme Faithful Companion Company. For a minimal outlay, a cup of coffee and a smile, I can be trained as a lifelong companion to vacuum the carpet, wash your dishes and scratch your back. Now, how about that?
You better come in.
Didn't like my sales pitch? Maybe you'd like a demonstration?
Look, Wally, it's been a long, hard day. If you'd like a drink.
I know. I'd prefer a smile.
I'm sorry, I seem to be right out of smiles today.
That bloody job getting you down again, is it? Look, I tell you what, now that Myra's back, why don't you take your break, give yourself a few days off her?
You know Myra's back.
She's been on every newscast for the past 4 hours. Anybody would think she was public enemy number one.
But you know differently, right?
We both know differently, don't we?
Strange how she just dropped out of sight. Maybe someone helped her.
Maybe they did. What's that got to do with us?
Nothing, I hope. So tell me again how you heard about Myra on the news.
Oh, God. Who told you? Myra?
I heard your voice when she called me. How could you, Wally, after what we talked about at the fete?
I wasn't in on it then. I promise you, look, she came to me needing help. Now try to understand that.
Oh, I do understand. I understand that I warned you, and you still just jumped in and aided an escape, and it could cost me my job.
Oh, it wasn't like that at all.
Oh, go away, Wally. I don't want to hear it.
Well, you're going to hear it. For God's sake, Anne, will you listen to me? That woman went through bloody hell with that kid. I don't know that I would have had that much courage.
You knew she'd escaped. I'm not talking about what's morally right. I'm talking about the law.
The law? We both know that the law's been proved to be an ass on more than one occasion. Look, come on. Are you telling me that you would have turned them away?
I don't know.
Yes, you do. You would have done exactly what I did.
That doesn't alter the fact that you're an accessory, Wally. If the police find out,
who's
you would...
Who's going to tell them?
Well, I'm certainly not, if that's what you're getting at.